the What If book tag. So this tag was created by Clem's Book Corner, which I'll link her video down below, and she originally created, and she tagged me to do this. And like I said, she tagged me, so thank you, Clem, for tagging me. I've been wanting to do a book tag in a while, and or for a while, I should say. And the point of this book tag is, it's like what if scenarios, basically, and I'm just really excited to do this book tag, so let's get to the book tag. So the first question is, what if you could live in a fictional world? This is a really good question, because a lot of times when I'm reading different books, like especially fantasy or sci-fi, I try to picture whether or not it's the type of world that I would like to live in. Mostly the world I would most likely like to live in is like Harry Potter, if I had a choice of a fictional world I want to live in, which is the Wizarding World of Harry Potter, of course. Like basically any fantasy, because it would be very cool to see like different mythical creatures going around like everywhere, like see different like phoenixes or other magical creatures flying with airplanes. I don't know, it just seems like the fantasy worlds are pretty, it would be very cool to live in a fictional world. So the next question is, what if you could rule in a realm or a city? I'm not sure if that would be a good idea, because I feel like I would not be a good ruler, because one, I would just make them do whatever I want without questions asked, and two, I just feel like I would not make a good ruler. I'd just rather obey someone else than be a ruler. I don't know why, it's just, I feel like if I was a ruler, I feel like not a lot of people would like me as a ruler. I'm pretty sure my friends would argue, like, I would make a great ruler, and of course, Kevin would say the same thing, like, I would basically just make people read books if I wanted them to, or he would say, like, he would make people play board games. In case you guys didn't know, he has his own YouTube channel teaching different board games, which I'll link, it's always linked down below. But it's just, it's really hard to think about. It's like, really? I don't know if I would make a good ruler if I rule any world or city. So the next question is, what if you could choose your family? And I know it's a good question, but it's also not a good one, just because I would not change anything about my family. I wouldn't, like, I just basically wouldn't choose a different family, because I might end up being somebody who I'm not if I chose a different family. But I mean, if I had to choose, like family-wise, I would pick the Weasleys, because I love the Weasleys from Harry Potter. Like, you probably will see that some of my answers will be basically Harry Potter related, but I'm just, don't think I would ever choose a family, but I do love the Weasleys. But that's like the only family I would choose, because I just love the Weasleys so much. The next question is what if my life is a contemporary book? Which, it really sounds interesting, just because I don't know if my life would be very interesting to talk about in a contemporary ask, unless my mental health would be very interesting, because I don't think there's a lot of characters that has similar, like, has same mental health as me. But I'm pretty sure, like, there is one I want to read, but I'm not sure how my life would be interesting as a contemporary story. That's just me. I think, like, mostly I think what would find interesting is what I went through in high school or something like that, or just mostly my mental health would be the most interesting part about my life as a contemporary novel. But I just don't think, I just think it's gonna be very weird if I would picture my life as a contemporary novel. So yeah, it would be interesting, but also not interesting at the same time. So the next question is, yeah, I'm looking at the questions on my phone. The next question is, what if you could marry or date someone? I don't understand about that question, because I'm already dating someone, and Kevin's been my boyfriend for almost 5 years, and I know we want to get married one day. Yeah, I mean, if I had to choose, like, which character I would marry, I don't know who I would pick, because there's so many characters that I love from high school that I'm like, I want to date a guy like that. Like, mostly the ones I could think of is PETA from The Hunger Games and Four from Divergent. I know people say that The Hunger Games is better, but I just love for so much, and same as Peeta from The Hunger Games. If I had to choose which characters I would picture myself marrying or dating, like back in high school, I would pick those two just because I love them both. But I do. I've been with my boyfriend for almost 5 years, and he's the one I'm dating currently, and we will get married one day. It's just if I tell myself if I had to choose a character who I would marry, it would be either PETA or Four, like I said. The next question is what if you could be a non-human character? That would be I don't think I've ever pictured myself. Like I'm pretty sure the question means by like if I was a wizard, witch, or an alien. I mean, for me, I don't know why I would picture myself as if I was a non-human character. Most likely a witch, because I do love fantasies in general, and I always think of what powers I would have wanted if I was like a superhero or a non-magic being or non-human being, I should say. So I would say like it would be very interesting to see myself as a witch using her magical powers in the library. That's like that would be basically me. So I think picture my like having that life would be very very unique or interesting, as I said that word a few times in this video. The next question is what if your life is a classic? I'm not sure how my life would be interesting, and it'll become a classic later on, just because like I said about my life as a contemporary, it would be interesting. I mean, if I wrote a novel that's about my life and how I achieve my goals, I think that would be very interesting, and my struggles along with it. Like I'm trying to publish my book currently, and I'm just like writing about my life, like in general, like from when I wanted to be a writer when I was 7 to currently, like me trying to get it published. I think people would hear my story and my struggles through my lifetime while I'm wanting to achieve my goal to be a writer. I think it might be a very interesting classic to read, but I'm not quite sure, seeing as I don't know how many people would actually want to read about my life. So I would say it just would be very interesting and really questioning whether people would want to read it or not. And the last question is what if you had to die and then pick a fictional character's death? That question really bugs me just because, like, of course, there's a lot of things I want to achieve in my life, and I mean, a lot of books that I've read with characters' deaths, some of them have sacrificed themselves to save the one that they love, and all that. I feel like it would be more like, I'm trying to think of a character death without spoiling it. And I'm trying to think of a book. I'm literally losing my train of thoughts right now. There's so many that I read about and really enjoyed it, and of course cried about it, obviously. So I don't know which I'm just giving like things that happen in books in general. I don't know which specific character's death I would bring up, because spoiler alerts if people haven't read those books, but I just think that question is very hard to answer, especially like when I'm trying to give a character's death, for example, when I've read so many of them that I don't know how to answer this question, to be honest. So that's all for the What If book tag. This was a very interesting book tag just because like how interesting it is, because I really like the what if questions, and you don't know what the answer is, but you want to come up with a synopsis, like a theory or something like that. But I did really enjoy this book tag, and also if you enjoy this video, I don't know who to tag because I really don't know who has done it or not, but if you want to do this book tag, go right ahead and do it, because this was a really interesting and fun book tag. Also, if you enjoy this video, give us a thumbs up and comment down below what if your life was a contemporary novel. I just want to see what your answers are for that question down below. Also, if you haven't already, click the subscribe button and click that bell icon so you'll be notified whenever I post new videos very quickly, frequently on this channel, like Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays. Also, you can follow me on social media like Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and Goodreads, which all links will be down below for you guys. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!